I'm Kerry Fink with Helping Seniors of Brevard. It's time for Helping Seniors Update. And on behalf of our president and founder, Joe Steckler, and our education specialist, Kim Bernard, and our whole Helping Seniors team. So today, we're so privileged to have another good friend of Helping Seniors organization. It's none other than John Roberts. He is Palm Bay Hearing Aid Center. And how are you today, John?
I'm doing very well. How are you doing, Kerry?
It looks great. It looks like you're just chilling by the river there. I love it.
Yeah, as long as the boat doesn't rock, I'll be okay.
That's terrific. So listen, you know, it's so funny. You and I did a Helping Seniors update a month or two back when we were in the middle of sort of COVID lockdown and things like that. And as we know, things are starting to open up a bit more. We're having the opportunity, for example, of seeing now possible with a lot of careful screening and things. We're having the opportunity of actually seeing some folks get to visit their relatives in assisted livings and things like that. And the report that I've generally heard through not only the assisted livings that we stay in very close contact with, but also the people who are going in and out of seniors' homes and providing in-home care. They're finding that as long as we do all those, they call them the universal precautions, that we're able to keep seniors safe and COVID-free, meaning, you know, social distancing, wearing of the masks, the frequent hand washing, making sure that we're not touching our face, eyes, and, you know, all those kind of things that they've told us to be careful with from day one. It sounds like when we do those things, we're able to stay safe. And I remember talking to you even in the middle of all that. You guys were able to continue forward, and I guess now, as we were just chatting, you're actually moving, able to move safely into another phase of business now for Palm Bay and make sure people are getting hearing help that they need.
Yes, we are, Kerry. We have found that if we schedule our appointments so that we don't have two or three people in the waiting room, we just do one at a time. Mm-hmm. We make sure that in between patients, everything is sterilized and wash our hands and keep our social distancing up, that we have a good, comfortable meeting and people aren't taking a big risk. You have to kind of weigh your risks. Hearing is more than a convenience. It's something that may determine your quality of life and a lot of aspects for your health and your well-being. So to come into our office and be in a nice, safe environment is a safe thing to do. And we encourage people to give us a call and set up their one-on-one appointment with us, Gary.
Yeah, you know, and I remember when we were talking before about this with the CDC encouraging that we wear masks. In fact, I've heard it said it's a patriotic duty because it really is about keeping the people around you safe as well. But I remember us having this conversation that particularly as we're wearing masks, and it may be the case at least for the time being, that makes it even more difficult for somebody that has hearing challenges to follow what's going on. I think you had a term, I want to say you called it speech recognition or something.
Yeah, speech recognition is greatly reduced. Even people with normal hearing, I have normal hearing, and when I go to a store, and the clerk is wearing a mask and there may be a glass between the clerk and myself, it's really difficult to hear, even with good hearing. But people that have a hearing impairment, it can be just so bad that it'll isolate them further. They'll just stay home. And isolation is a risk for early onset dementia and for your quality of life. So the masks have been absolutely horrible for anybody with even a mild hearing loss. Or people with hearing aids, they still don't have complete normal hearing. It's still a challenge, but without them, it's impossible.
Yeah, you know, we've joked a lot about, you know, we're used to taking a lot of visual cues in general anyway, you know, if somebody's smiling or frowning or whatever the case may be, and then you stick a mask on it, you know, I've heard people say, well, I'm trying to watch the eyes and see how the eyes are and things like that, and people try to make a lot of accommodations, but I can only imagine that if you're experiencing a hearing loss, you're going to throw that on top of everything else. And now even not having the ability to have those visual cues would just seem to really amplify the hearing loss problem.
Oh, tremendously. About 30% of our speech recognition is visual. Uh-huh. And you're taking that 100% away. You're not going to tell much by somebody's eyes. You need to have their whole expression. Right. And their body language, everything combined is what's going to give you that speech recognition.
And I remember too, we did a radio show a while back, and I remember we were getting into this particular conversation that a lot of times some of the symptoms of even dementia or things like that may possibly actually be just challenges with the person being able to respond because they're not hearing things correctly or not able to understand what's going on audibly.
Well, yes, dementia, Alzheimer's are linked to hearing loss. We've known that for over 20 years. Wow. John Hopkins University did a study about 8 or 10 years ago conclusively demonstrated that people with a moderate hearing loss may be up to 300% higher risk for getting early onset dementia. Mm-hmm. The top symptoms of dementia are basically the same as the top symptoms of hearing loss. So we may have somebody that will come in with their parents and say, well, mom has dementia. And we say, well, who diagnosed that? Well, nobody, but you can tell. Well, maybe she doesn't. Once we put the hearing aids on her and she responds and she's in a better mood, maybe she's just fine. So before anybody gets a test for dementia, they really should get their hearing tested first and take it from there.
You know, and that goes back to the whole thing that you said about isolation. You know, I was thinking under a good time, if a son or daughter would come in with mom and say, well, you know, maybe she's got dementia, you know, and it would turn out that it's actually related a lot to hearing. Then I think, you know, under the best of circumstances, that person's feeling pretty isolated because they're not really able to participate in what's going on around the household. And in the worst case, when we're really under lockdown and people aren't supposed to necessarily be just freewheeling visiting like maybe we've been used to in the past, that just exacerbates that whole situation. And it really makes it cry out for the ability to make sure that you're able to hear what's going on.
Now, it's monumentally made the situation worse to be isolated most of the time, as everybody, I think, is right now, because we just plain don't want to go anywhere. And when we do go somewhere, we're under the stress of our social distancing, right, of the precautions that we're taking. But if you're not going to be able to understand somebody, and you know you're not going to be able to understand them, you're probably not going to go out. So you're going to deprive yourself of some basic necessities and just entrench yourself in that house and make your social isolation 10 times worse. We're finding people are just coming in horribly depressed and tremendously stressed out over the situation because of the masks. They're a necessity, but if you have any kind of a hearing problem, they just take you right out of the picture and double your problem with stress.
That's why it's so good to know that there is a solution through what you guys are talking about and your ability and your experience and all that. Before I got there, I wanted to ask you too, you know, because we've done some Helping Seniors updates where, interestingly enough, a lot of the people who are involved in looking after seniors, they're making the argument that now that everybody's getting a better understanding of how COVID actually transmits and the things that you can do to prevent that from happening, it seems like medically there's a reasonable path to making sure that we're able to stay safe. But now the challenge really seems to be coming up, is this about isolation? And so everything that we can do to combat those feelings of isolation, and it really does, from what we're talking about, seem like getting your hearing straightened out is really one big part of the quality of it.
Yeah, and the good news is that the hearing aids have just made some of the companies that produce the hearing aids have just done incredible improvements on the circuits in the last few years. The hearing aids are capable of separating speech from background noise, isolating that speech, and then bringing it right to the brain so that people can understand it without exerting a lot of effort. The improvements that we've seen in the last few years are the biggest improvements I've seen in 30 years of fitting hearing aids. It's just incredible. As soon as we put them on their ears, their faces just are exuberant. I've never seen anything like it, Gary.
Yeah, I remember seeing a YouTube video or something that went viral. It was a baby who had hearing loss and got to hear the mama for the first time say, I love you. And you could just see that face light up. And I'm sure that is an experience that you see some variation of that when you put hearing aids into a person that has really been tragically missing out on so much. It just must like open up the whole world.
Oh, it's just heartwarming, Gary. For somebody that may have not heard very well for about maybe 20 years, and within 1 minute that all comes back and their auditory memory is spurred, and, wow. and the looks on their face is just unbelievable. It's just like the baby, only it's something that they recognize, that they know they've heard before. Yeah. And we bring it back to them.
Oh, that's so good. And you guys are really experts in this. I was thinking about this as we were talking about it. I know we've had the conversation. You have been in this business and studying and following the advances in hearing technology for years and years. And you've really impressed upon me that, you know, number one, the technology is just moving by leaps and bounds. I remember you telling me, like, yeah, you do come in for initial hearing fitting and testing and things like that. But literally, even past that, then you're able to, through a smartphone, help people adjust the hearing aids just with that technology. So they don't even necessarily after that have to come in the office.
Yeah, that's a new technology, remote programming, that we can program the hearing aids right over the internet while they're on the telephone with us. It's a wonderful thing to have. The most important aspect of purchasing a hearing aid is buying it from somebody that's going to take care of you.
Right.
I get people that come in with the best hearing aids in the world, but they're in a drawer because nobody's there to take care of them. The people they bought them from may be gone, or maybe they bought it on the internet or whatever. But in order to keep the hearing aids in your ears and out of a drawer, we need to set appointments, which we do with all of our patients. We don't charge for these appointments. Once they bought the hearing aids, all these follow-up appointments are at no charge.
Wow.
And every 4 or 5 months, we'll have them come in. We'll look at the hearing aids, clean them up, and do a speech recognition test to make sure that they're doing well. If they need a hearing test, we'll test their hearing, reprogram the hearing aids. But that's the only way that you're going to keep the hearing aids in your ears and working well.
You know, I was just smiling because I was thinking about, this is a kind of an off the air or behind the scenes story, but you had come into the radio station and we did a radio show with Joe Steckler, our president and founder, and we were talking about hearing aids. And I remember he had literally brought in some very expensive, I think, hearing aids in a box and said, you know, I'm just not able to get these to do exactly the right thing. And you were literally, because of your experience, on the spot, able to leave him. He was able to go home from the radio station hearing properly. And it just, I think it's really a testimony to the experience and your knowledge of how to really help people get the best hearing. It was just a funny story because I remember how happy he was with all.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you got to know what to do. Yeah. Every day we have dozens of these appointments, or at least a dozen. And quite often the patient will come in and we'll say, how are you doing? I'm doing wonderful. But within 10 minutes, we see they're not doing so well. Right. We'll find a problem, maybe a little piece of earwax in the hearing aid or something else. But we'll solve it for them. They didn't even know they had a problem. But by the time they leave, they're very happy because they're even hearing better than they thought. So
now that's so good. And by the way, viewer, if you get a chance, we archive every single radio show, every single TV show. And there are some very good TV shows that we did together with John and the Palm Bay Hearing. And we talked about the hearing loss and the things for Palm Bay Hearing Aid Center. We also did that radio show. You can actually catch that radio show as a podcast. Just listen to it as you choose. You can get all of those on the Helping Seniors website. You can just put in search and those will come right up for you at helpingseniorsofbrevard.org. You can also find them on our YouTube channel, Helping Seniors of Brevard. And you can also find them actually on our Facebook page at Helping Seniors of Brevard. So lots of ways to access that material. But John, if people want to, you guys are open for business. So I want to make sure people know how to reach you so that they can get an appointment. And I remember you explaining that visit cost nothing to have your hearing evaluated and do that.
Yeah, that's right. We'll see anybody at no charge. We'll test their hearing at no charge. We'll work on their hearing aids. If we can fix it in the office, there's no charge. All they have to do is call us at area code 321-369-9900.
So one more time, that phone number?
321-369-9900.
Absolutely. And you should give John and his team a call there. It's just a fascinating conversation about how hearing can make all the difference, particularly in these challenging COVID times where we're wearing these masks and doing all that. And speaking of challenging COVID times, John, I want to take just a moment and tag up about the Helping Seniors car raffle, because, you know, we are coming down to the 3-week mark. Actually, on Saturday will be 3 weeks to the Helping Seniors car raffle. And if you remember, that's our major fundraiser for the year. So we have together with AJ Hires of the Boniface Hires Car Dealerships, Joe Steckler, our president, and AJ have come up with a really amazing offer this year. You get to pick out your choice of a brand new 2020 Chevrolet Camaro, 2020 Dodge Challenger, 2020 Kia Sportage, or a 2020 Mazda Miata convertible. And it's going to be fun to see what the winner chooses on that day of October 10th, 2020. And hopefully that's you that are making that kind of a decision. That's a tough decision, but it'd be a fun decision to make. Somebody is going to win keys to that new car on October 10th, 2020. Now, we will be broadcasting that full day from the American Muscle Car Museum. We're actually going to start out in the morning at AJ's car dealership, so you'll be able to see those beautiful cars that are up in the car raffle. You'll be able to see them actually as we broadcast live on both Facebook Live and YouTube Live from the dealerships. And then starting at 2 o'clock, we're going to be out at the American Muscle Car Museum, and lots of great surprises. We're going to have lots of great visitors. John, I'm hoping you'll be able to pop by. We're inviting all the Helping Seniors participants to come on to the Facebook Live and say hello and talk about the work of Helping Seniors and supporting Helping Seniors. We are not, because of COVID restrictions, able to open up to the public. So there's not we can't have a crowd event like we did last year. If you remember, we had 2,000 plus visitors during the evening for the grand drawing. So this year we are restricted and we have to do the drawing only on Facebook Live, but we're hoping you'll be able to tune in. However, and this is the important however, your ticket not only gives you a chance at winning the car, but your ticket will be good for admission to the American Muscle Car Museum. What owner Mark Pylock has generously offered to do is, he said, as soon as the governor relaxes the restrictions where it's safe enough to have a small crowd inside the building, he's actually going to open up for 3 days and allow Helping Seniors car raffle ticket holders to tour the museum at their leisure. So everybody won't be compacted into a couple hours. We'll be able to be spread out. He said, look, I'll even buy the pizza and soda for everyone that day. So we're going to make it a nice day for seniors in Brevard at the American Muscle Car Museum. So your ticket will still become an admit one to the American Muscle Car Museum on those selected dates. And we will let you know as soon as we can tell you what those dates are, but they are forthcoming. And so your ticket will be good for that in addition to a shot at winning the car. So what we're telling people is you buy the $100 ticket raffle bundle, which gives you 5 Helping Seniors car raffle tickets. And then you will know on October 10th, win the car, don't win the car, whatever the outcome is on the 10th, you will still have 5 admission tickets to the American Muscle Car Museum, and you'll be able to invite your friends. So we'll still be able to have a nice party out at the American Muscle Car Museum for the general public. It's just not going to be able to happen on October 10th. But the car giveaway does happen on October 10th. And John, that's also one other point. Your office is a ticket pickup point. So people, while they're in there getting their free hearing check, they can also go ahead and pick up tickets there at your office.
Yeah, in fact, we're right there at Palm Bay Road near I-95. So it's easy to get in and buy your ticket and be on your way.
That's right. So as we wrap up for today, let's make sure one more time, this is John Roberts. John is you're just like the expert when it comes to hearing aids. I'm trying to remember you have this long title with all these great accolades about being the hearing expert, but you've done this for so many years.
Yeah, I've been doing it for over 30 years now, and it's never been more fun than it is right now. We finally have the technology to really help even people with real big problems with their hearing.
So again, remember to write this down, Palm Bay Hearing Aid Center. It is literally so convenient, right off of I-95 at Palm Bay Road. And John, once again, the phone number so people can get in touch with you.
Phone area code 321-369-9900.
Great.
Easy to remember.
I think so. Well, thank you again, John, for taking the time and helping us get our hearing checked out and where we should be going, and also check out for those Helping Seniors Car Raffle tickets. You can get them online also, helpingseniorscarraffle.com, helpingseniorscarraffle.com. But why not make the trip in and pick them up at Palm Bay Hearing Aid Center, and let's make sure your hearing is in tip-top shape too. So seems like a great way to go. So thank you, John. We're going to continue on, and we will actually have a special edition of Helping Seniors tomorrow from the American Muscle Car Museum. It's all getting us ready for that car raffle. So folks, we'll see you again tomorrow. And meanwhile, on behalf of Joe Steckler, our president and founder, Kim Bernard, our education specialist, we hope you have a great rest of your Friday. And thank you, John, again for joining us today.
Thank you, Gary. It's a pleasure.